This is Roosevelt Gist with AutoNetwork, and we're here in Los Angeles with Hyundai for the launch of the new Elantra and Tiburon. And my guest on the show is the brand new COO, Steve Wilhite. Steve, welcome back to the U.S. and in your new position.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be back. My wife is thrilled.
I hope you answer this next question. As you know, two Korean car companies have recently let go of their most senior American executives. Knowing that, and Hyundai being one, why did you take this job?
I think it's an opportunity to work with a great brand, a great company, at a particularly dynamic time in the history of the company. We've achieved unbelievable results over the past 4 to 5 years by every measurable metric. Sales volume growth, quality growth, I mean, number three behind Lexus and Porsche. That's pretty extraordinary company. And consideration for the brand is moving in the right direction. Our product plan is terrific today. We have the youngest, freshest product in the industry, and the future product plan that I've seen in Seoul is just off the charts. So I'm thrilled to be here, and I think the opportunity is great.
And what are some of the things that corporate Hyundai expects out of Steve Wilhite?
I think there are really three things that they have a right to expect. Number one, volume and market share growth in the United States in support of the product investments they're making. Two, a fair and perhaps maybe better than average return on invested capital in the United States. And three, growth and definition of the brand so that we are a clearly defined, powerful brand in the United States. So when people walk down the streets, they've got a very clear and positive attitude about just who Hyundai is and what we stand for in the American marketplace.
Now, have you had enough time in the position to kind of map out what you'd like to see done in the next 6 months? And if so, what are those?
Well, I've only been in the job for 60 days, so I think that it would be unfair for me to comment on all of the things that I see. But I would tell you that I've been running at lightning-like speed. I've been in Korea to meet with our key senior executives and to see our facilities and to see our product plan. I have met with our dealer advisory council on numerous occasions. I've met with leading dealers around the country. I have visited each one of our regions and reviewed our business literally district by district and dealer by dealer. And I think I have a pretty good handle on the issues that we face and the opportunities that we've got ahead of us. We just held our national dealer meeting in Chicago, Illinois last week. And we laid out the basic architecture of our plan at that meeting. I would say that it was a very unusual meeting from our dealer's perspective, but that the information was very well received.
From the presentation this morning, you obviously have great product in the marketplace. You know, people are buying the product. And at those dealer meetings, or what's been the response of the dealers? What are they looking to see different from Hyundai?
Well, I think really the dealers are looking for two things. One, they're really enthused about the product program we have in place today, and they're just wild about the quality that we're bringing to the marketplace. So that's really half the battle. I think the two things that they're really looking for are, one, marketing leadership and brand definition. You know, again, they're incredibly proud about the brand that they represent. They're just frustrated that not more people are considering our brand, or that people's perspectives of the brand aren't more clearly defined. So I think that's number one. And number two, I think that the dealers are looking for a spirit of cooperation and active engagement with the dealer leadership. They want us to become full-fledged partners. They want to be involved in our business, and they've got a lot to contribute. So hopefully they think that they found a willing partner with the new COO.
Now, in terms of marketing dollars, obviously you don't have the big bucks like some of the other car companies. You do, even though you have some unique and interesting product. What are you going to do to get that message across to more consumers so that you can get that brand recognition in the marketplace?
Well, first of all, I guess I'd want to explain that we have plenty of resources to communicate. The real key for us isn't a resource issue. The real key for us is clarity and definition of defining exactly who we are and what we stand for so that all of our employees around the country, all of our dealers, all of their salespeople around the country have the same perspective and can walk a little taller and feel a little prouder about being part of the Hyundai brand. And we're doing a lot of work in getting that right and being very clear and very precise. And I guess I'd have to tell you that you need to stay tuned. But the big issue isn't resources. The big issue is clarity of message and relevance of message in the market. And boy, we've got a really a powerful brand and a powerful message. You know, some really great stories to tell that I just don't think we've been telling as effectively as we need to.
Well, this is a medium that obviously gives you an opportunity to tell that message. So what are some of the things that you would like for people watching this webcast to know about, say, the Hyundai brand that they may not know now?
Well, I'd really like to share maybe four things, if I could. The first is that Hyundai manufactures affordable cars that are technologically advanced vehicles. And we build passenger vehicles that are leaders in safety and interior ergonomics and interior functionality. And we compete in segments that are very popular segments in the marketplace. And we think that we bring a very fresh perspective from a design language to the market. And I guess the final thing I guess I'd say is we're really a wonderful brand that that offers extraordinary value, that provides great security. As you know, our products are backed by America's best warranty. And we're a brand that people really are discovering, and when they discover it, feel really smart that they made a great decision. You know, it's not that they couldn't afford more expensive cars, it's that they're choosing to buy Hyundais because we offer extraordinary value and they don't need to spend any more money. And the great thing about our customers is, one, they're very loyal to our brand. We have the third highest loyalty in the popularly priced segments. And two, they feel that they discovered something really unusual. And the neat thing is that they like to share that information with others. So we think we've got a real powerful tool in our growing owner body that's going to be even more valuable for us in the future.
Now, what really excites Steve about the Hyundai brand, the Hyundai products?
Oh, geez, you know, it's very interesting. In my former capacity, I had an opportunity to experience the company globally, to see what they were doing in China, to see what they were doing in India, to see what they were doing in Eastern Europe and Western Europe. And the investments that they were making and the direction that they were taking, I thought were absolutely right, and really building a solid foundation for to become a truly dynamic global competitor. And the more that I've learned about the company since I came on board, the more powerful those beliefs are. Our investment in Nam Yang, our R&D center there, is just, it's incredible. It's not just state of the art, it's really state of the world. Unbelievable facility that gives us incredible capabilities for new product development and design. Our manufacturing facilities throughout the world, absolutely state of the art. Our Alabama factory came on board really without a hitch, just, you know, fantastic quality, hit our production targets, just, you know, really a wonderful investment in building a strong foundation for us here in the United States. So from my perspective, all of the good things that I saw are being paid off in spades with my actual direct experience.
Now, personally, when you drive one, what excites you about the product?
Oh, the fit and finish and the interior functionality more than anything else. I mean, I think our cars are beautifully styled. We've got terrific active and passive safety systems. But the thing that really sets them apart is the interior fit and finish and quality of materials. The value that we provide is absolutely extraordinary. If you haven't been in a Hyundai, I can tell you, you're going to be quite surprised. And if you compare our products directly, not only with traditional cross-shopped vehicles, Toyota and Honda perhaps being the two greatest, but you compare them with premium brands, you're going to find that the fit and finish and tactile qualities of our cars rival the very best in the industry. It's extraordinary, and that interior functionality is wonderful as well.
Great. Steve, thanks for taking the time, and good luck in your new position.
Thank you very much. My pleasure. It was great being with you.
Thank you. This is Roosevelt Gist with AutoNetwork, and we're here in Los Angeles with Hyundai for the launch of the new Elantra and Tiburon. And as always, please buckle up, don't drink and drive. See you next time.